Hi guys, welcome into today's video. Today I want to do a bit of a different video and a more similar video to the ones we were doing in the past with the keyboard and try to explain you all the reasons why we are seeing what I call a silent crash, where several stocks go down and down and down and down and the indices don't go down as much as several stocks. So everything has been there are many reasons behind, but I believe that the reason that has triggered the sell-off of the last days is the war, is the second war in Israel. And I would like you to understand the reason why this is happening, what are the mechanisms, because it's important for you to understand, to try then to figure out how we can get out of this situation. So basically the wars in Israel have several consequences. The first of all is treasury yields. What I mean by that? Biden, in order to finance this war, needs to sell, expand the budget that will be spent on foreign affairs, on help on Ukraine, on help on Israel. He needs to finance the war, he needs money. So if Biden wants, let's say, to take out more money from the US government, what is happening is that there are two ways. Either raise taxes, okay, imagine I am a government, I need to raise taxes, or I can put on the market new bonds, new treasuries to get money, because when I put treasuries, I make even more debt, but I get money that I can spend on the war. Taxes is not the time because there are the elections next year. Treasuries are seen a possibility. So the government releases bond. And who buys this bond? We got, let's say, the buyers. Buyers could be the Fed. But the Fed is doing quantitative tightening because the objective to win inflation, so will not help. And we have states like China that are becoming political enemy of the US, and they are not gonna finance US buying bonds. So no one is buying the bonds. If no one is buying the bonds, the price of bonds is dropping because there is supply and there is no demand, and the interest that the government needs to pay for finding someone that buys this bond gets higher and higher and higher. And this is creating two circumstances. One, if bonds that are presumably without risk, but we don't know that these are really without risk because the debt to GDP of US is very, very high. If bonds are giving you 5-6%, some capital get out from the stock market and go into bonds because they are chasing this 5-6%. So this is not good for stocks. The other factor why this is impacting, if you saw my course on investing, you could see that a discounted cash flow model of a company is equal to the sum of the cash flow divided by the cost of capital. When the price of debt, the bond yields are increasing, the denominator, the cost of capital, is increasing. So with cash flow being static, the value of a stock is going down. On top of that, it's making more difficult to refinance at the higher rate. So there are a lot of problems associated with the value of the stock. And if you will appreciate this kind of video, guys, please share a like, share with your friends so that they will know that you might like this video. So this is the second point why we are going down. Then there is a third point which is called tax harvesting. What is tax harvesting? Tax harvesting means selling stocks at a loss in order not to pay taxes in the stocks that you have, the winning ones. So, I give you an example. If you have Eli Lilly that made you 100% this year and you want to take profit on Eli Lilly, you will have to pay the tax on that. And for some funds, it might be a lot of tax. So what are you doing? You sell the stocks that lost money this year, like the Pfizer, the Enphase, these kind of stocks you sell because of tax reasons, because declaring the loss, you will, let's say, have an advantage on the tax. But the thing is that buyers are gonna come back in these companies because these are, in my opinion, what a lot of smart money is doing, winners of the future. So money will come back, but right now the market has the expectation that as they are at a loss, they will sell more and more and more. So that's an additional problem we have. Tax harvesting. And this is related, the narrative is related to the tax harvesting. Because in order to help these stocks get crushed more and more and more, for example, what Wall Street invented in the last days is the narrative that if you take the pills in order to get slimmer, people will not eat anymore at McDonald's, will not eat chocolate, will not drink Coca-Cola anymore, will not go to restaurants. So these stocks were already crushed thanks to the narrative that they create, they push retailers to sell more and more and more. So Wall Street is trying to manipulate you, like last year they were trying to tell you that Facebook will not grow anymore, that there was TikTok. Any kind of narrative is good to help shorting stocks and healthy stocks go down and down and down. So you need to be careful. The next problem is that these wars can create a rebound in inflation because, especially if Iran enters in the war, these are countries that are providing oil to the rest of the world. If they reduce the oil, let's say less oil, the price of oil will go up, and if the price of oil will go up, inflation will go up. If inflation goes up, the Fed has to keep rates higher for longer, which is not an advertisement of a sexual medicine, but unfortunately is the scenario we have. Inflation will go up. That's another bad scenario that is connected to this war. So there were mechanisms that were already fragile. These wars have been exacerbated everything. The next biggest problem, second biggest problem, because the biggest will be the world war, which we really hope to avoid independently on how markets will go, is the recession, because these higher yields make a problem with consumers with credit cards that have to pay higher yields, so there is a risk. They create a lot of issues. So the next issue, there might be a looming recession that anyway, we are not seeing from the retail sales that were very, very high, from unemployment. So we will see if we will have the recession. And now the last question, what I'm doing in this market? I'm keeping strong, I'm buying the dip in the companies I believe that will provide value in the future, and then if this wars will get better, if this recession will arrive, it can go even lower. Anyway, when I look at what the companies will earn in the future, I do my discounted cash flow, I see what the smart money is doing, I believe there is more chance that these stocks at these prices will give me upside than downside. So I try to keep strong, and I wish you guys keep strong as well. There were many crises in the history. Eventually, what the market does goes up because of inflation, because of GDP, and if you have the best companies, your portfolio will grow in the long term. Thank you. Have a nice day.